Hello and welcome back to Uipath ExpoHub. Today we are going to learn the URL validation part of regular expression chapter 9. Guys, myself Rakesh. I would like to thank everyone for the very beautiful comments coming on all our videos, that you are liking the teachings. Thank you very much. Please do like all the videos that you are watching in Uipath ExpoHub, and please do subscribe in case you have not. Thank you very much. So let's get started. So the very first thing is, I have copied a different type of URL people might type. Okay, I am taking a very simple example. So they might type it wrong, or they might, you know, so this is wrong, right? You are having so many W's. So when somebody enters that, it should not pick this data, and it should say that your data is incorrect or the URL is incorrect. So this is correct. Third one is correct. This one is correct, right? So it can have an underscore, and you can have some kind of a letter. So this is correct. This is correct, right? So, and this is incorrect. There is no .com. This is incorrect. There are only two W's. So with this kind of situation, how do you create a regex which can identify what is right and what is wrong? Okay. So this is what we are going to learn. Now, to start with, you don't take into consideration everything. You just start with what is correct. Okay, this is the best sample to start with, and then we will, you know, modify to see how do we adjust it. Okay, so very simple. So let's understand, while building regex, it's not complex. It will be only complex when you don't know where to start. So my recommendation would be to start with the best case. So this is the best. So this is the correct one, right? This could be the correct one. So I am just taking this as an example, and I'm going to start writing the code. And while I go, I will modify and develop it. Okay. So that it can fit all my conditions. So how do I start? So the very first thing is, your URL can have HTTPS www. So for this one, let's write it. How do I write it? So very simple. So I will first use a moon bracket, and in the moon bracket I will simply say HTTPS. Okay, then it can have a colon, right? So colon, so this is what it is selecting, HTTPS colon it has selected. After that, it can have a forward slash. So forward slash is a special character, so you will use a, you know, backward slash and then a forward slash. So it is highlighting the same thing. I am going to repeat, so it's going to highlight. You can see it here, right? It has highlighted. Now the next word could be www, and then again use a backward slash and put a dot, because dot is also a special character. So now you can see it has selected the HTTPS www. Now let me think, what if it doesn't have a S? It could be HTTP, right? It cannot be a secure URL all the time. It could be HTTP. So if it is HTTP, then how to write? Simple, use a, you know, pipe symbol, which is just like OR, and then I'm going to write HTTP colon. So what is happening now? The below one got selected, right? And I'm going to repeat the same thing for the forward slashes. Okay, and then forward slash, and then what comes? www, and then a dot. So these are the two conditions. You can also have sites like FTP, right? Starting with FTP, again you have to repeat the similar way. You put a OR symbol and then write FTP, right? So whatever your URL in your environment, you can just keep on writing like this. So that way it is highlighting everything. Okay, but what could be the other problem? Let's say somebody says abc http s www.google.com. so what is happening in this case? Even this one has been highlighted. So the HTTP or whatever the words are here, it's supposed to start at the beginning, right? Otherwise it's going to highlight everything. So what I'm going to do for that, I'll be using a caret symbol. By using a caret symbol, what would happen? This one is not highlighted, if you see, right? It is not highlighted. So that is how you have to design. So I have used the caret symbol, done. After that, what comes? After the www dot, you have a google.com. So for that, what to write? How will you write for that one? So it's very simple. Use a square bracket, and it can have small a to z, okay, or it can have uppercase a to z, or it can have words like 0 to 9 numbers, or it can have some symbols like exclamation mark, or it can have a underscore, or it can have a hyphen, or it can have a dollar symbol, or right, all these things are possible. So all these things could be there. And then after you write all of this, you have to use a preceding character plus sign. So having a plus sign, what does it do? What does the plus sign do is it is going to highlight, okay, everything. It could be even 4-letter or 5-letter or as long as it is going to highlight that, okay? So sometimes the URL will have a longer sentence, right, longer characters. So it's going to highlight whatever the numbers are, doesn't matter. Okay, after that, what comes? After that, you have a dot, right? So after the plus sign, what I'm going to do, I'm simply put a dot. Clear? I have put a dot. After that, what comes? .com, .in, .comment and all that, right? So for this, what I'm going to write is, again, the same thing. Use the square bracket and then write A to Z or A to Z. Right, it cannot have a number. Generally .com, .in, .gov, .edu, all of these things will be there. So there is no number, so I am not going to write a number around that. Okay, after that, there is something you need to understand. Most of your domain could be of 2 character, minimum of 2 character, or it could be of 5 character. Okay, so 2, 5 I am mentioning. So that way it will select. So anything like if I put .com ABC, it's not going to highlight. Okay, up to 5 characters it's going to highlight. Okay, fine. So that I have done. And then remember one thing. So what is happening sometimes, this .com has to be at the end of your expression, right? It should be always at the end of your expression. So for that you have to use a dollar symbol. So that donates that it is always at the end of your expression. So it's not the end symbol, it's supposed to be the dollar symbol on the character 4, right, on your keyboard. So dollar symbol. So you can see it is just highlighting whichever sites are correct. Okay, whichever things are not correct, it's not getting highlighted. Now if you see www.abc.in, that is also correct URL, but it's not highlighted. So for that, what I will do here, again I'll use a pipe symbol. Okay, and here I will simply write www dot. Okay, so what is happening? Even the www dot got selected. And now let's come to the next one. So the next one has a hyphen, adf dot in. So if there is a hyphen, how it should be selected? So let's see that. So now this hyphen here, I have to mention a word hyphen, right? If not, it's not going to work. So let me simply say this. Okay, A to Z 029, and it can have a hyphen. So for that, backward slash hyphen. Okay, so now you can see even the hyphen got selected. Now the other problem is underscore is not getting selected. So for underscore, again you can use this underscore. So now you can see everything got selected. So this is how you need to continue to build your regular expression. There is nothing to remember, all is that it's an experimental thing. You test it, right? That's where it says test. So you start testing it and start developing your entire regular expression. So now what I'm going to do, I'm going to copy this to my UiPath, and in the UiPath, what I'm doing, I'm using an input dialog where it is going to ask customer enter your UR for validation, and then that gets stored in the input variable, and the input variable becomes the input for the EaseMatch activity. Okay, so you must know about this. So if you go to string, these are the 3 activities which are built for regular expression. So I'm using the EaseMatch. So EaseMatch would give you the boolean value whether it's true or false. Okay, so EaseMatch, this is your input coming from the input dialog. And then what I'm going to do it here, whatever the match is found, it is getting stored in OP. So here in the EaseMatch, click on configuration and I'm going to select advance. Okay, so there is a already pre-built regular expression which is there in email, which is more robust for sure. But again, when I used it, it was not able to validate. If I'm typing www.google.com, it is saying it's true. Reason being, it is not validating what is the, you know, pre-characters are there. It is just taking whether the proper URL is there inside the entire string or not. Okay, that is one of the thing which I found. So for that, I thought, let me build it my own. So I'm building it my own. Okay, and then click on save. Okay, so once you do that, okay, what is going to happen? The output is going to stored here. If there is a match, then it will be true. If it is true, then it is saying that is correct. If it is false, then it will say that is incorrect. So I am using a switch activity. Very simple. So you can build this yourself. So let me run it and let's do the testing. Okay. So the very first thing I am going to enter is www. So this is incorrect, right? Google.com. So that is incorrect. Please re-enter. Now, let me try to enter the proper one. Let's see if it is able to recognize that or not. Okay, so let me try www.abc-123.com, let's say. Okay, click OK. So that is correct. Thank you. So it is recognizing the URLs in a very nice way. So you can build this out yourself and see if you can validate the URLs. Okay, this is one of the very useful activity which you need to learn and understand. Okay, again guys, please do like and share all the videos you are watching. Share with your friends. Please do comment. I love to read them. How do you feel about this video? Please do subscribe to our channel. Now I'm thinking the next video what I'm going to come up would be on orchestrator. Let's see if there is some other situations where regular expression you wanted to learn. If possible, then I'll get few more examples. Otherwise, we have already covered lot many examples, and I feel that should be good enough for anybody to continue, and you know, you can advance on that one. Now the next chapters what I'm thinking is to come up with the orchestrator videos. Okay, orchestrator itself is a very critical chapter, and there are so many minute to advance things that we need to learn about orchestrator. So I'm thinking I will build a series on orchestrator. So thank you for all your support, guys, and my subscribers. Thank you very much, and you guys have a wonderful day.